sunny down here.
Come up from
blessed.
I told you.
Her name is Marisol. Give it up for Marisol. Give it up for all of you. I'm gonna do some spoken word in Spanish. Levanta la mano quien habla español. Okay, if you don't know Spanish, get close to somebody that just raised their hands and they're gonna be translating for you.
Okay, I'm gonna tell you, I don't speak Spanish.
Alright? Aquí llegaron las hormigas. Vamos conquistando tierras, nuestras tierras. Invisibles, silenciosas y simultáneas. Toda la reocupación es subterránea. Sin disparar al aire, sin tirar misiles, sin tener que matar gente usando proyectiles. La guerra la peleamos sin usar fusiles. De bloque en bloque, como los albañiles. Han tratado de pararnos un par de vaqueros, pero ya está construido nuestro hormiguero. Somos muchas hermanos, hermanas, con muchos primos. La familia es grande porque nos reproducimos. Destratamos al vaquero de sus oficinas porque trabajamos a tiempo completo, sin propina. No somos bienvenidas, pero como quiera entramos, te picamos y te castigamos. Cuando más te confías, las hormigas te engañan, atacan en equipo como las pirañas. Aunque sean pequeñas, gracias a la unión, todas juntas formamos un camión. Pobre del vaquero que nos subestime, cuando se duerme, se le viene la colonia encima. Por eso los vaqueros en todas las esquinas los tenemos comiendo comida latina. Las hormigas pueden contra cualquier gigante. Entran por la trompa de cualquier elefante. Los derrumban sin que la sangre les salpique. Ácido fórmico para que les pique. No te confíes si la picada no te arde. La quemazón de la picada se siente más tarde. Aunque tengas botas vaqueras y sombrero, hay muchas hormigas y pocos vaqueros. Los humildes se comieron a los dos, a los nobles. Para el 2020 vamos a ser el doble. Aquí no hay racismo, aquí no se trata de raza. Si trabajo aquí, pues aquí tengo mi casa. Ser imparcial, de eso es que se trata. Hay que compartir los dulces de la piñata. Ahora si el vaquero viene y nos maltrata, puede ser que a las hormigas le salga lo de zapata. En equipo se resuelve cualquier contratiempo. Cuando te picamos, picamos al mismo tiempo. Sobre nuestra unidad no debe haber preguntas. Frente al peligro, las hormigas mueren juntas. Un país durmiendo es un país desierto. Este gobierno se asusta cuando me los que no se pueden contar. Entre las patas, nunca escondo el rabo. Prefiero morir como rebelde que vivir como un esclavo. Apuesto, y eso va para ellos. Apuesto que los tuyos se rinden primero. Porque los soldados míos no pelean por dinero. No le tengo miedo a las confrontaciones, porque yo me crié con invasiones. Y como las hormigas, si tengo mala suerte, defiendo mi hormiguero hasta la muerte. So, thank you all for being here. Sorry, my throat is a little sore from chanting since 7 in the morning. But we just want to highlight and echo everything that folks have said already, especially around the importance of building community, building relationships between each other, solidarity between our communities. And we believe that fighting under the leadership of the folks mostly and directly impacted by the different systems of oppression, colonialism, capitalism, imperialism, heteropatriarchy, white supremacy, fighting under the leadership of working class, queer and trans, black and black, brown and indigenous women. That's gonna not only have the leadership that we need, but it's gonna fight the struggle that is gonna improve conditions not only for those folks but for everybody. So within our communities, we need to be organizing, talking to our neighbors, right? Building people's institutions, not only actions that last one day and then we forget about the struggle. We need to be building long-lasting our families, our neighbors. We need to be challenging white supremacy and what that means in each of our communities. As an indigenous and brown woman, I need to be challenging colorism and black racism within my community. Within our communities, we need to be challenging patriarchy. Look at who are we throwing down for? Who are we investing in developing their leadership so they can lead our struggle? Power to the people. Power.
Whole street?
Our street.
Whole city?
Our street.
Whole street?
Our street.
Whole city?
Our street.
Yeah, I love it. I love it. And the sun's coming out. We got all these good things coming out. So please, I would like to welcome Tiny from the Peoples Project and Poor Magazine. So give it up for Tiny.
I am the poverty scholar. Criminalized, racialized, and always in struggle for $1. I am the poverty scholar. All the people you don't want to see, never want to be, look away from me. What you gonna do? Arrest me? I'm in your city. I am the poverty scholar. And I rock this jailhouse attire because me and my po' mama did jail time just trying to stay alive in this holler. I am the poverty scholar. The melanin challenged daughter of a strong black Indian mama, for without whom there would be no me, a mama soltera and a welfare queen. Woo! So first of all, I just want to say love to all these liberators of the streets. Yes! Take back these stolen streets, this stolen justice, and this gentrificated Valencia street. To all you walkers of liberation, that we can actually take back shit and not just do the public fix halls, right? Infiltration. So first of all, I want to give it up always to the original gentrified people, our lonely peoples upon whose land we are humbly standing. Please give a round of applause for all our ancestors, our kids. Talking about gentrification and state-sponsored violence if we're not talking about the peoples who came before us who suffered the same genocide. All of our black and brown peoples who built this stolen indigenous land are the ones who are being incarcerated in plantations created by the man. These are no accidents here. So when we unpack all these acts of injustice, let's continue to speak and be along with the ancestors who came before us. Last of all, I want to give it up to the homie in the eBay bus, so I hope he's getting paid. Big love to you, bro. Whenever you feel like it, liberation is possible. But bloodstained dollars are real, too. And that's part of the reason that there's not more folks here with you, right? Because we're all caught up in this lie of we gotta make a dime. We gotta make it. We gotta be better than somebody else. We gotta get mines, right? So part of the issue here is to deconstruct the ways that most of our peoples are caught in these low-wage, no-wage lies called jobs. And all of us also have to have respect for our brothers and sisters who are still in those trabajos, right? Our trabajadores brothers who are right down now on Cesar Chavez trying to get a little tiny crumb from the man. So these things are all connected. And lastly, I want to say, again, love to the liberators here. Love to the people walking this revolution. Love to the mothers. Lopez, Ashe, Alex Nieto, all of our brothers and sisters taken away by these plantation systems that tell people to take you out if you don't look like somebody else, right? But lastly, I want to say that on May 1st, a whole coalition of other comrades across the state who are just like you down in L.A., Santa Barbara, San Jose, we're going to be standing together against state-sponsored violence and gentrification. treacherous Fox Nation as First Nations, poor black and brown people standing together. And so I want you all to put down all of our issues that we might have between us revolutionaries, because we always got funk and mess that takes us apart, and actually love each other. That the cheese tray doesn't matter. And what really matters is fighting the real enemy, the devil loafers, the gentry fuckers, and the pro-life state.
This brings us back. Sorry, I've been losing my voice for like 5 days now, so I'm pushing it. So please give a warm welcome to Cynthia from Causa Justa.
Hi everyone, I'm Cynthia, and I'm an organizer with Causa Justa Just Cause. And just to get warmed up, we're going to do a quick chant. And so we're going to say this time, hang in there with me, a bit of a mix. Rise up, resist, no killer cops, no jails. Because we don't want our people in jails, not our people in jails, right? The whole damn system is guilty as hell, just for a minute. So rise up, resist, no killer cops, no jails. The whole damn system is guilty as hell. Rise up, resist, no killer cops, no jails. The whole damn system is guilty as hell. Rise up. Resist! No killer cops, no jails! The whole damn system is guilty as hell! Resist! No killer cops, no jails! The whole damn system is guilty as hell!
So, as I said, I'm here with Causa Justa, and Causa Justa is an organization based out of Oakland and San Francisco that works with black and brown communities to fight displacement at a local and at a global level. And we see displacement as being driven by development, by neoliberal policies, by neoliberal development that are only, whose only purpose is to further capitalism, to further development in our home countries, to displace our people, to force them to migrate, to force them to die crossing borders out of hunger, out of thirst, to be exploited in this country, to be exploited in their working conditions, in their housing, by their employers, and then be killed by the cops. So what I wanted to share is that we see the global displacement and those policies that happen by governments like the U.S. deciding to move into our home countries and displace our people, the same thing that they're doing here in San Francisco and Oakland through gentrification, and using the state, using the military, and using the police here to further enforce that displacement and to enforce the safety of those new people coming in and to enforce the safety of those corporations in our home countries displacing our people from their lands. And we are here to say that we've had enough, that there can be development for our people, there can be housing for our people, that we do have the right to stay in our home countries, that we have the right to stay and not be forced to migrate, that we have the right to stay in our lands, to cultivate our lands, to live in our communities and not be forced to migrate, and we have the right to live in our neighborhoods without being killed. And we have the right to live in our neighborhoods without our rents going up, without being displaced by our landlords, without having the sheriffs and the cops come to enforce that displacement, and without having them killing us on the streets. And so we are here to stand in solidarity with the family of Alex Nieto and Amicad and all those families who've lost loved ones to the violence, to state violence, to San Francisco Police Department violence, to government-sanctioned violence in our home countries. And that solidarity extends to our organizing day to day to fight to stay in our neighborhoods, to fight to stay in our home countries, and to fight to stay in our jobs with dignity, justice, and a living wage. And that we're not going to stop organizing until we get that. That our people are not going to stop until we get justice for Amir Khan and Alex Nieto and all those murdered by the police. And that we're here in solidarity with you all. And that we're going to continue to rise up. Resist, no killer cops, no jails. The whole damn system is guilty as hell. Rise up, resist, no killer cops, no jails. The whole damn system is guilty as hell. Rise up, resist, no killer cops, no jails. The whole damn system is guilty as hell. time that we are all here sending each other energy and wishing us well and making sure that we're good. So drink your water, you know, acknowledge each other. Keep doing that. Keep doing that. We're strong. We're here for 4:15, right? 4 hours, 15 minutes, critical resistance, right? That's what we are going to have Woods from Critical Resistance come up and say a little something for us to hear. Welcome Woods, everybody.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. My name is Woods Irvin, and I'm a member of Critical Resistance. Critical Resistance is an organization committed to abolishing the prison industrial complex. Surveillance, prisons, courts, and police. We at Critical Resistance stand in solidarity with Alex Nieto and his family and all those killed by policing. It is awful that black and brown people from this city have to live in fear of cops. Cops who are employed to surveil the streets for the people who actually are the members of the community. It is outrageous that people kill black and brown people police kill black and brown people after targeting them. And it is disgusting that families and communities of Alex Nieto have to challenge narratives of criminality in the media, that after the police have taken their family member away, they have to prove his innocence in order to even demand accountability. And then that the SFPD can hide those responsible. It is all devastating and unfortunately so typical. At CR, we know that police don't keep black and brown communities safe. From the beginning of police departments in the United States, their job has been to target black bodies post-slavery and brown bodies as part of Western expansion. The echoes of this can be felt in gentrification in SF and the construction of new police facilities and the proposed SF jails. We know that the way to stop the killing of our people in San Francisco, in Oakland, in Salinas, in Ferguson is to remove policing from black and brown communities. Instead of more guns or body cams or anything to police, we need to keep fighting and organizing for resources to go to more affordable housing, more jobs, more schools, not a new jail in SF, and no more police.
Rise up, resist, no telecops, no jails. The whole damn system is guilty as hell. Rise up, resist, no telecops, no jails. The whole damn system is guilty as hell.
Folks have been holding it down here on the game. Let's give them some love. So our folks have been holding up the banners, hauling up that Google bus or that eBay bus, whatever. Give them lots of energy to our security. To all the organizers that made this possible. But I got to speak about why we're here, right? I got to speak about what has brought about these actions that brought us here today, that we have to protest. We try to understand why these killings continue to happen on a daily basis, not just in San Francisco, not just in Oakland, not just in Missouri or New York, but all across the nation. We have to start questioning the type of system that we live in. We have to start questioning whether we're looked at as human beings and what type of system allows us to be dehumanized where we can be killed even worse than dogs, because even dogs aren't being shot on the street. Human beings are being shot on the streets, right? And that only happens when you live under an occupied military force that's really here to spread imperialism, really here to spread capitalism all over the world and steal resources, right? Our brothers and sisters are sent to start wars all over the world, not for the benefit of our security, but for the benefit of the rich. The oligarchs who really control this country, right? Who really send us out there not because they care about our safety, but they care about the safety of their riches. The safety about their oil, their water, and other natural resources that are taken straight from our people in the Philippines, in Mexico, Central America, Southeast Asia, right? Africa, all of these places. We have to ask ourselves, do we really have freedom in this country? Do we really have democracy when the two political parties that you vote for are controlled by the rich, right? When more than 40% of our congressmen, of our people who are elected officials, are multimillionaires.
Yep.
Do they really know anything about ending poverty? Do they really know anything about what it is to bury your brothers and sisters who have been killed at the hands of the police when they live in gated communities protected by the police?
Right.
What do they know about suffering? What do they know about injustice when they don't have to spend their times on the street? The reality is that all of us here are two paychecks away from being homeless, and that's the reality, right? Many of us are living, working, whether it be in a nonprofit sector, whether it be as teachers, and we're scraping by. Many of our family members are living in a one-bedroom apartment with multiple families because they can't afford to live, to have food, put food on the table, or to have the basic necessities that human beings deserve, right? Food. That as poor people, as working class people, that we must resist in all forms. Right? That today is not only about justice for our brothers and sisters who are dying every single day, but it's also about justice for humanity, for our dignity. That we will no longer take living as slaves and working for the rich, but that we will work for our brothers and sisters and work to build up our communities. When we start to control our education system, when we start to control our economic system, where workers have rights and we're able to organize ourselves, where we no longer have to listen and sell ourselves short to work for somebody who's just benefiting the rich, right?
Revolution!
So I've been a long time worker organizer. I'm from the peninsula, from South San Francisco. And, you know, that work is very much hard. The people who live out in the suburbs are dealing with the same things you guys are dealing here, right here in these communities, these urban cities, right? We're dealing with gentrification, right? Where the cost of a two-bedroom apartment for a family is reaching up to $3,000 a month, right? We're getting to mortgage levels of trying to find somewhere to live. And where are we going to live, right? We've been pushed out to Oakland. We've been pushed out to Pittsburgh, Antioch. We've been pushed out to all these areas. But at what point do we say enough is enough? At what point do we say you can no longer kill our people? You can no longer pass laws without our approval. Today it's about standing up for justice in our way. We see that the court system has not given us justice. We see that we always come to the court system and there's never an indictment. There's never anybody prosecuted for the wrongs of what they're doing to our people, like Alex Nieto, to the people like Mike Brown. We don't see that type of justice. So today is the beginning and the continuation of seeing justice in our way. We're holding the trial today, right? We're holding the microphone. We're holding the space because whose streets are these?
Our streets.
Whose streets?
Our streets.
No justice?
No peace.
No races?
No peace.
No justice?
No peace.
No races?
No peace.
You fight racism with solidarity, right? And that's what we have here today, right?
Yeah.
Solidarity. Beautiful faces from all colors of the rainbow. And I just want to say thank you for allowing me to be in this space. And we will win. We will continue to fight this and we will march on. Thank you.
So, earlier, if you guys were here, if y'all were listening, I was talking about healing for like 2 seconds, you know, and not only organizing is part of my healing process, but something that was introduced to me at a very young age, age 12, was poetry, You know, poetry kept me from picking up a pistol. It kept me from going off on teachers. It kept me from being a very angry child. You know, it just gave me a source of expression instead of violence, you know? And then it also introduced me to the community of organizing. If it wasn't for poetry, I wouldn't be here for y'all, right?
That's right.
So, if y'all allow me the honor, I just wrote a piece like 5 seconds ago. And I want to share it with y'all. Is that okay? I get that as a guess. Okay. FTP can have so many meanings. It can stand for fuck the police, fuck that puto, fight the power, or for the people. But it has me thinking, is the world we live in real? Is it alive? Or is it just a nightmare that I replay every day? This world is so unfair, so cruel, where only the few rule. Race structures known as disruptors, I pinch myself to the point of blood as I feel my heart flood with anger, sadness. I feel my eyes burn, waiting for my turn in the line for the second crime of the week. My knees weak in this world, nothing is on fleek. The only real is the reek of injustice. Blood and tears, our fears won't go away. This system has tears like a cake, but it tastes disgusting. Gut-crunching, eye-burning disgust. This means it's a must. Stop believing in a pitch and wake the fuck up. Damn, the love. I love it. Love the love, man. I gotta love the love. It's all good in the hood, right? I am going to read our demands again, because that is the reason that we are here. We want everybody to hear us, everybody in this area. We want all the fucking Valencia to fucking hear us, right? So here go our demands. Paper difficulty. Sorry, I'm losing my voice. So, we are here to stop police impunity and to start the accountability. Yes?
Yeah. Yeah.
Second demand. We want to fire and prosecute killer cops and their accomplices, right?
Yeah.
We want to be known that gentrification is violence against working poor communities, right?
Yeah.
And we want a people's trial and justice on our own terms, right?
Yeah.
That is what we want, that is what we need, that is what we demand here, right?
Yeah.
Whole street, whole street, whole city, whole city,
whole city. Tenemos aquí recordando nuestras demandas desde San Pancho al mundo. Queremos que termine ahora esta impunidad policiaca ante sus crímenes y violencia. Queremos que los oficiales que participaron en el asesinato de Alex Nieto y estos asesinatos que están pasando día a día en nuestra comunidad sean identificados y que les quiten sus puestos de trabajo. Decimos que el aburguesamiento de nuestra gente, de nuestra comunidad, es violencia en contra de la gente obrera, trabajadora. Y queremos, lo que hemos representado hoy, es un juzgado del pueblo, justicia popular, para estos asesinos que tanta discordia y violencia siembran en las calles. Hemos estado aquí 4 horas, 15 minutos representando nuestro hogar, nuestra lucha por la ciudad, no 415 San Francisco, el 415, el aburguesamiento que hasta nos ha quitado tanto. Pues es algo que está pasando rápidamente y tenemos que actuar ahora. La policía usa el código 415 para representar los disturbios, pero sabemos que el disturbio de verdad es su violencia ante nuestra gente. Y por 4 horas hemos estado solidarios con el movimiento afrodescendiente Black Lives Matter en el norte, centro y Sudamérica.
So translate her last part. We're going to talk about why we are here reclaiming this space. Because whose streets are these?
Our streets!
Whose streets?
Our streets!
We are here setting this place down for 4 hours and 15 minutes. Now, 1 second less, right? And our reason for being here is because this is our home. We're from the 415. We're from Frisco, right? Also, trying to talk about how gentrification is a race. I know I've said it hella times, but it's so important to keep repeating and repeating so everybody has a second ear, right? We got city college that they're trying to shut down.
Hell no!
That college is for our people, by the people, right? Knowledge is power, and if we don't have access to it, we don't have power, right? Gentrification is directly connected to shutting down our school system, to shutting down City College, and it's not okay. And finally, last but not least, we are here for 4 hours and 15 minutes in solidarity with the Black Lives Matter movement, right? Yeah! Make some noise! So, now, blockaders, you guys say unblock. And we are going to rejoin our brothers and sisters on the other side of the Google bus, right?
Right.
So, blockade, you guys will be leading us, and Loco Bloco, you guys will follow behind them. You guys ready?
Yeah.
And everybody out here, I want you guys to rally up behind us, and I want y'all to dance. I want y'all to make some noise. I want y'all to chant and scream and show all the passion and love that y'all have for this community right now.
Thank you.
senseless defendants who serve our community every day. On the evening of March 21st, 2014, these four officers right here responded to a 911 call of a man sitting on a bench on Vernon Hill. These four men risk their lives every day to defend the callers. They responded to the scene, ready for combat, because their life was at risk. So they unloaded 58 shots, 16 of which hit Alex.
That sounds like an assassination.
What was this man doing on Bernal?
Hold on. It says, according to my statement, that this man was, Your Honor, was eating a burrito.
Well, why was he wearing his uniform if he was a security guard?
Your Honor, he was wearing his uniform. On Friday evening, March 21st, 2014, shot and killed by a terrorist on Bernal Hill Park. Without the officers are here for you on trial for the murder of the community leader Alex Nieto or an all Hill
resident. Does the defense have anything to say?
Yes, I do, Your Honor. And the people of San Francisco. So a dog walker called 911 because he was suspicious of this young Latino working class man on Vernal Heights. We believe he was acting erratically.
Who was acting erratically? The officer or Mr. Nieto?
The dog walker.
Your Honor.
Please approach the bench. What did you see, witness?
Your Honor, I saw Alex. He wasn't hurting at all. He just seemed like a tiny burrito.
Thank you.
Yes, Your Honor, the 911 call and dispatch audio, Alex was described as having a behavior at the end, never saw. He was never described as threatening anyone. All the same defendants that he was killed in blood. Alex, yes, was no threat to anyone on her own.
Witnesses say he was carrying a gun, Your Honor. Your Honor, my defendant confronted Alex as he was walking down the hill on his way out of the park and killed him with two sequential bullet shots. The first bullet took him down to the ground. The second bullet shot, over 10 shots, killed him.
The judge and people's jury will deliberate. Is there any other evidence that prosecutors would like to present to the people?
The prosecution also has an issue with how the prosecution scandal. 8 hours after Alex was killed, officers interrogated members of the family for 45 minutes and detected a warrantless search of their home before they informed Alex's parents that a police had put their son. Officers also
controlled FTP!
No jail!
that's justice. That was right. As I mentioned earlier, as a moral people, if there is something being done wrong, we have a duty to make it right. And justice has been served.
Justice on our own terms, and we got that today. Yeah.
for 4 hours and 15 minutes. Something that would have been seen as impossible, but we did it. People put in their hard time, their energy, their blood and tears into this, and we're here now. And the reason for holding it for 4 hours and 15 minutes is that this is our home. Whole street?
Our street.
Whole city?
Our city.
Right? This is our city. We are from the 415. 4 hours and 15 minutes. We also want to acknowledge that gentrification and is a race against time. We are here in our community. Gentrification is a race. It's stamped against us. And we're making that very clear that for 4 hours and 15 minutes, it's not about that. It's about us.
Yes!
415 is also the police code for disturbance. And we're not here to disturb the peace because our peace was long taken away. We're here to disturb business as usual because money has always been the motivation in this capitalistic society. And we're taking that away today and saying, no, our lives matter. We're here. And finally, we are here in solidarity with Black Lives Matter.
Yeah.
Por última vez, las demandas de hoy y la razón que hemos estado aquí es para demandar un fin a esta violencia policíaca, que se identifiquen y que se despidan los asesinos de Alex Nieto, que el aburguesamiento es violencia en contra de la gente de clase laboral. Y por fin, queremos crear justicia entre nosotros mismos. Tomamos esta calle simbólicamente 4 horas y 15 minutos representando 415, 415, el lugar donde hemos nacido, crecido, llorado y donde Alex Nieto sacrificó su vida. Estamos aquí solidarios con la familia Nieto y todas las madres y padres que han perdido a su hijo. Estamos aquí por 4 horas solidarios con Black Lives Matter y los pueblos afrodescendientes en lucha en todo el mundo, en nuestros países y aquí. También, y finalmente, reconocemos que esta policía asesina usa 415 para representar un código de disturbios. La paz sin justicia no hay paz. El respeto al derecho ajeno es la paz. Y los disturbios son necesarios porque no aceptamos su autoridad. No es legítima su visión de la justicia. ¡Asesinos!
I will introduce one of our closing parts. Please welcome Sharif doing Toy Toy. Thank you.
What's up, everybody? I'm Sharif, and I'm here with Third World Resistance and AROC. I have my comrades here. We're about to close out. Let's give a hand to all the organizers and all the beautiful MCs that are out here throwing down.
So, before we close, I want to know, I'm
going to
tell you guys why. Because our brothers and sisters, our allies, who have been locked up there, who have created our gate for us, are about to unlock. And as they do, I want you guys to give them as much power, love, and energy as you possibly can. Make that voice go silent so your throat hurts. Ready?
Comes together. We say particular phrases that re-emphasize our calls
We emphasize our unity. We emphasize our power. And you just respond by saying, hoi, hoi. You got to leave.
Just last month, it was decided that four San
Francisco officers. You got to lift your knees. You got to raise your voices. You got to pump your fists.
This morning, protesters.
So I'm just going to make some calls. The brother Armel and Sharif are going to respond with hoi, hoi. And you all join in, dance around, pump your fists, and let them hear you. Let this police station hear you, because we're here today. Folks couldn't join us today, but from Oakland to this Mission Street, the Staten Islands, the Palestine, to the Philippines, we're going to continue to build this movement and keep this struggle going forward. So just say hoi hoi in response to the calls. Raise your knees. Let them hear you. Raise your knees. Let them hear you. Raise your fist. Up to the sky. Up your fist. And punch the sky. My people, people, are you united? Then we ain't never gonna be defeated. People, people, we are united. We ain't never gonna be defeated.
YouTube in about 2 days.
Okay, thank you.
who genuinely serve, protect, and integrate with the community are being targeted by the FBI, the CIA. Will the U.S. government declare a war on the society in which we live in? And as a family, as a community, it's our duty to fight and gain victory to serve, protect our homeland. One of our own, Brandon Lee, an SFA graduate, an SF native, has fell in love with the Philippines and continues to empower and organize indigenous communities in order to sustain their livelihood, to preserve a dying culture, and to be a humble servant for the people. In return, the government attacks, labels, and vilifies acts of love. And with that, we defend Brandon Lee, and we defend Alex Nieto. We defend our homeland, the Cordilleras, the Ferguson, New York, Mindanao, and San Francisco. The militarizing must stop, and the people must resist oppression to prevent another child's life from being taken so soon, so that we can all see our families flourish and inherit a better world. Stop police impunity. Justice for Alex Nieto. We demand police impunity to stop, and Black Lives Matter. Thank you. Woo! Yeah.
I'll be on YouTube in a couple of days.
Right on. Cool. Thank you.
Keep that.